Welcome to SCN Corporate Connect. I'm Greg Greenberg, reporting live from the Thomson Reuters headquarters in Times Square. My guest is Patsy Doerr. She's the Global Head of Corporate Responsibility and Inclusion at Thomson Reuters. Welcome, Patsy.
Thank you very much. Happy to be here.
Okay, so thank you for hosting this Decade of Women event. We've been celebrating it all week over at the UN and here in Times Square. What does the Decade of Women initiative mean to you and your work here at Thomson Reuters?
No, it's a great question. It's really important to us, and we're delighted to be hosting the event here. And having been at the UN yesterday, it's been, as you said, an incredible week. And I think for me personally, part of my role, if not my entire role, is really to be a change agent and a voice in the world, frankly, about gender equality and corporate responsibility and the intersectionality between those two topics. So really having that opportunity to share our story and to bring other organizations together to work on these issues is the primary reason why I'm particularly excited about it. From a Thomson Reuters perspective, a key element of our business strategy is our focus on diversity and inclusion, and particularly gender parity. And so we ourselves actually announced a 40% women in leadership target about a year ago that is needed to be achieved by 2020. And so we have an aggressive diversity and inclusion agenda ahead of us to meet that target.
And Thomson Reuters is famous for its data collection. You have the data on everything. So can you talk about how you use that data to try and encourage inclusion so people can know which companies hire women, which companies don't? How do you use it?
Oh, it's also a great question and near and dear to my heart. So yes, we do have a massive database that tracks environmental, social, and governance data on 6,500 companies around the globe, industry agnostic. So it's the largest database of its kind. And how we utilize that is in two ways. Number one, we package it and sell it to our clients, particularly in the financial services business. But number two, what we've done most recently is actually to create a diversity and inclusion index, where we narrowed down, of the 400 metrics that we measure, we narrowed it down to 24 that define diverse and inclusive environments. And we launched that once a year so that companies know how well they're doing against their diversity and inclusion targets, as do we, by the way. We're on the index as well. But secondly, the index was created with investors because part of the objective is to help investors make decisions on those companies that are doing well in diversity and inclusion.
Well, data is one area of technology where people are using it to encourage diversity and inclusion. We've also heard a lot about the blockchain. Mm-hmm. Can you discuss that a little bit? Because it's a solution that just keeps popping up. We're going to use the blockchain to solve a lot of problems. How are we using it here?
Also, very interesting, and I think that's a topic that's evolving very much here at Thomson Reuters. As you know, in addition to being a data company, 50% of our employees are technology experts, really. And so we have a heavy focus on blockchain, AI, and the linkage, again, getting back to our data sets, to ensure that we're looking across the entire supply chain against all of these issues, whether it's diversity and inclusion and other issues along the lines of human trafficking and things of that nature. So really working out a strategy so we can look across the entire supply chain.
And then finally, over the past year, we've heard a lot about women's issues, gender equality, the Me Too movement, the March on Washington. How do you make sure we keep the momentum going? We've had this great kickoff event here for this decade of women. How do we make sure we just don't lose it as the news topic changes and the social media topics change and whatever's on cable TV, people change the channel? How do we make sure we keep this thing going?
So I think that we are at a real tipping point, and this has come up in the conversations both yesterday and today as well, and that we're at a critical time in our society, both from a geographical perspective, from a political perspective, and from a societal perspective. So voices are louder and bolder than they've ever been before. So there's now a pressure on companies, individuals, and the public sector as well to address these issues. And so I think if we don't address these issues now, we're not going to make that progress that we need to make. If we look at some of the research, if we are stagnant at the level that we are now or keeping to the strategies that we have in place, we will not achieve gender equality for 100 years. So we need to keep this going. And I think the beauty of this event is getting people together who care about this stuff on an ongoing basis. So this is the start of a dialogue. It's certainly not the end, and we have lots of work to do.
All right, well, it's been great speaking with you. Thanks again for hosting the event.
Pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you for watching SCN Corporate Connect.